I'm Jason with the All Things Open team here. I have Rishab, and we're going to dive into a couple topics, AI, DevOps, and a lot more. But Rishab, please introduce yourself to the All Things Open community.
For sure. So I'm Rishab. I work as a staff developer evangelist. I have worked in the infrastructure engineering space before moving to DevRel. So I did cloud ops, DevOps. But also, I started my career in tech support, or doing help desk, because that was the least barrier to entry role I could get after my two-year computer networking diploma.
Got it.
So that's how it started, and it's been around 6-7 years now in the industry, and it's been going good.
Great. Well, let's dive into a little bit of AI. What excites you about the intersection of AI and DevOps?
Oh, that's an interesting one. I think we currently are at a point where it can help strategize a lot of the DevOps tasks, mm-hmm. and also can help with a lot of automation. I also want to see it to go to a point where it can do deployments. So, think about natural language deployments within a cloud provider. That would be the dream. But I think currently it's at a great state where you can also do analysis and stuff on traffic and security incidents and stuff if you provided logs.
Got it.
I've tried that myself. Does a pretty good job.
So I understand you're passionate about cloud computing. And what's new and interesting these days in that arena?
Ooh, I think infrastructure as a service, we went to the serverless, cloud native Kubernetes containers a few years ago. Mm-hmm. But now I think we are kind of coming back to infrastructure as a service because of all the AI stuff.
Yeah.
So you still need compute to run these large language models or even train your own AI models, and compute is expensive.
Yeah.
So you have to rely on these cloud computing companies like Microsoft, AWS, Google are the big players, and I think also operational excellence is what I'm also seeing based on the trends. Companies are trying to spend very less on their cloud bills, so they're hiring these engineers and architects who can strategize and bring down their cloud costs and make sure that they utilize the compute that they have within a cloud to its full potential. So operational excellence in hosting AI.
Okay. I was going to ask if you had any tips on cost savings, but it sounds like people are having whole teams of people to just save money.
Yeah, I think it's a hot, if you are trying to start your own business and you have some experience in cloud, you should probably consider consulting, specifically saving costs.
Got it. Do you have any tips or best practices for the All Things Open community?
Ooh. Just in general?
Yeah. Doesn't have to be specific about AI or DevOps. It could be a productivity tip.
Yeah. Touching grass is an important one. Someone being from Canada, we get a very long winters, and I already am not so excited about it because the summer is going away. The reason is I stay indoors for the most of the time. On top of that, I'm passionate about tech. So what happens is I'm working 8 to 5, but then also spending 5 to 9 still working on my screen, which is, again, there are very serious implications to your health. So I think get involved in some kind of community. It doesn't have to be tech, even though I love going to meetups, meeting other passionate people about tech, but see what you can do outside of tech. I personally like playing volleyball and soccer. I play in 2 competitive leagues, and that's what I try to disconnect from, my screen.
Got it. Away from screen time. I love it. I'm a big fan of that as well. You are the co-author of a book called Learn to Cloud. Can you tell us what that's about?
Hey, this is Todd with All Things Open. Thank you so much for watching. We truly appreciate it. Also, be sure to subscribe to the channel and hit the notification button. We've got a lot of new content coming we think you're going to be interested in. One final favor, be sure to go to allthingsopen.org, allthingsopen.org to see everything that we do. Back to the video.
Sure. So as you predicted early on that I'm very passionate about cloud, I was on this self-taught journey. So from tech support, which was the initial role that I got into tech, I figured out I don't want to do tech support for the rest of the life. And I started, pivoting into software development, QA, or cloud. Those were the 3 options. And cloud really clicked with me. I'm like, this is super cool. You can rent out servers just like I rent my apartment without owning a house. this is cool. I want to pursue this. But see, back then there were not a lot of resources that were open and free
right.
and open source in nature. So it took us some time. By us, the co-author is Gwen. She works at Microsoft now. She's also self-taught. You know, she just did her high school, doesn't have a computer science degree. So we had some battles to figure out what resources would work, what the journey is like, what should we learn, what is the missing knowledge gap. So it took us a year to pivot. And we want to make that process more efficient for people who are trying to do that now.
Got it.
Hence, the Learn to Cloud is the title. It's not a book. It's an open source guide. So all of it is available on GitHub. If you go to learntocloud.guide, it's an open source repo. And you can check it out. It basically upskills you to be in a cloud role.
Perfect. Do you have any advice you can offer to help conference attendees who are here learning a lot? What do they do with all this knowledge after the conference?
After the conference. So I hope you're taking notes while you're attending these talks. And whatever talks you attend, I would say pick out the two or three that really resonated with you and you also feel like, oh, this is something that really interests me. Dive deep into it. You know, go through whatever technology was being used. So let's, for example, if it was Azure, in my case, I will stick to cloud computing. Or if it was AWS, a certain service was being mentioned in the talk, dive deep into it. See how you can use it or how you can help your company use that service to build a new tool or new service. So dive deep into it. Also, the second tip would be to keep those connections that you made during the conference. Of course, you know, it's after COVID, we are all virtual. A lot of the companies you work from home now. So these conferences, I find it, you know, a great opportunity to meet these amazing people in the community in person, but keep those connections alive by following up, you know, either on Twitter, X, LinkedIn, whatever your social media is. Just keep those connections open.
Sounds great. That's great advice. All right, Rishab, thanks for your time today. Appreciate it.
Thank you for having me.
All right.